Welcome to the Campus Recreation Wellness Center in Oshawa, Ontario. Men's volleyball matchup between the 4th-ranked Durham Lords men's team. OCAA rankings just came out this week. Durham 3-0, ranked number 4 in the province against Algonquin, who are 0-2 and unranked. Should bode well for the Durham team going into this game. Rory Langley serves for Durham. Get things started. Here we go. Andrew Watson from the back. I'll tell you, Watson and Coleman are driving me nuts because they keep changing numbers each week. Watson 11, Coleman 10. Serve too strong. Point Algonquin, one apiece. Gareth Luke starts off serving for Algonquin from Lisgar High School in Ottawa. He's a first-year player. Jansen up. Looked too strong. Algonquin kept it in play regardless. Harrison Wood. Harrison Wood with the kill. The big man's been dominant so far all season. Off to a great start tonight.
Yeah, great job by Harrison Wood there with the kill. Lord's able to make good net presence and a couple hard smashes early on right at the net.
Jansen serving for Durham. OCAA All-Star Eric Jansen. Harper and Watson were there, but ball went out of bounds. Point Algonquin.
Unfortunate break for the Lords. The two guys at the net, great net presence. Ball just got tipped out of bounds there, unfortunately.
A.J. Westcard will serve now. Another first-year player for Algonquin. Langley for Harper. What a kill. Mike Harper finds the back corner.
Great job by Harper with being able to attack the net and find that back corner there.
Harper service now. One of, if not the best servers on the Durham men's team from the action I've seen so far. Wow. Oh, net violation. Stephen Patterson went up. Like, impressive hops there. The vertical was crazy, but got too much of the net on that one for the ref's liking.
Yeah, Patterson really attacked the net there. Great job of the Algonquin player. And the Thunder were able to get the point with the net violation. Or, sorry, the Lords were able to get the point.
Harper serves it into the net. That'll earn him a seat on the bench. Braden Rogers, libero, checks back in for him.
There we go, complimenting people.
Yeah.
Can you point out that he's great at serving and next thing you know, one of the
net. He'll get it going. He's. I have faith in Harper. Jonah Neiman. Wood again. Patterson attempted the block, but Wood just too strong. Big man just dominant. 6'5" frame. Uses every inch of it, getting up to get that ball and hammering it down.
Yeah, Harrison Wood, the lone international player on the Lords, making a great impact already from Nebraska.
Wood, service again. A lift there called on Gareth Luke. You can hear it from up here. Durham off to an early 7-3 lead. Harrison Wood serving for the third time.
Wood serving again. Allow me to correct myself. He's actually from Uxbridge.
Yep.
I was actually informed.
He told me not to say Nebraska. Luke there too strong. Hits it up the back. So. Had a chat with Harrison a week or so ago.
Well, he never told me so my apologies. My apologies, Axel Harrison, the Uxbridge native.
There's maybe 4 or 5 players from the Durham men's team, all Uxbridge natives, played high school ball together. I know Langley, Watson, Wood, and I'm missing somebody. There's at least 3 or 4 of them together.
Rogers down there.
There he is, yeah. Rogers, yeah,
Braden
there's the 4 of them, yeah. Jansen call with a lift. Ref a little bit more stringent in this game with the lift calls than the women's game earlier. Durham with an 8-5 lead. Justin Kingsbury serves for Algonquin. Gets the lucky roll. Hit the lip of the net and it rolled in.
Just a tough break there for the Lords. The Algonquin player, Kingsbury with the serve. Got lucky at the top of the net. Really unfortunate break for the Lords.
Cheap one, but he'll take it.
Yeah, the Lords are going to rebound here, though.
They're not so lucky that time. Hits it right into the net. You can't pull that one twice in a row.
The key for the Algonquin team today, with a bunch of strong players on the Durham side, they can't be having those errors like that going into the net, serves going into the net. They can't be doing that, or else they're going to find themselves in a lot of trouble all day.
Watson, impressive athlete with a powerful serve. Gets the point for Durham, 9-6. Watson, another one of those Uxbridge natives, Uxbridge High School. Sports management student. The first-year player for Durham. All these Uxbridge guys, first-year players, bodes well for the future for the Lords moving forward in this men's program. Luke up. Nick Coleman's there with the block.
Great job by Coleman. And he also had Langley there on his right side helping him out. They're able to get that block up and get the point for the Lords.
Watson will serve again. Taking his sweet time. Powerful jump serve. He's calling another lift there. Bit of a generous call for Durham. Nonetheless, they'll take it. 12-6 Durham early in the first set.
Great job by Watson. Really impacting the game early with a couple really strong serves as the Thunder coach calls a first timeout here of the game.
Algonquin wants a timeout early to regroup, think about it. Kind of a weird timeout. There's no momentum kind of going either way, but nonetheless, the Algonquin coach wants to talk with his players.
Yeah, I think they just find themselves in a quick hole. It's 12-6 early here. They don't want to get this to get out of hand. They're going to try and rally the troops and get themselves into a little bit of a groove here early in this game.
Early impressions, Steven Patterson, 6'3 player, first year out of St. Catharines, Jamaica. Really impressive athlete. This guy's jumping out the gym. Just watch his vertical and warm up and here early on the game.
Yeah, the 6'3 player, he's really using his whole body, really getting up, really making sure he uses the height advantage that he has to try and hit that ball onto the Durham side.
For Durham, the usual suspects. Although it looks as though they are without star player Matt McGurr, number two, dominating for Durham in first couple of games and leading in just about every statistical category. But not in uniform tonight. I think Durham will be okay without him tonight. Luke. Rogers there. Rogers got a piece of it. Not enough. Point to Algonquin. Patterson serves now. Kind of an unorthodox serve. Powerful nonetheless. Wood up. Harrison Wood again with the kill.
Great job by Harrison Wood. He's got that strong kill shot. He's going to be using it all day, and the Lords are going to need it here.
Coming into today's action, Wood's already got 29 kills, adding to that total. He's averaging 3.22 kills per set. It's dominant numbers. Luke up. Way too strong. But I think they're calling a...
Looks like
Langley got called in.
Yeah, looks like it was a net violation on that one. Algonquin's going to get the point.
Rory not too happy about it, shaking his head, but... Not much you can say now. Adam Waller serves now from Sarnia, Ontario, St. Clair High School. Second-year player for Algonquin. Kind of ugly there from Jansen. He was down in a good position to kind of bump that, opted to kind of set that up and Not sure he made the right choice.
Yeah, got hit with the lift call there, unfortunately.
Langley for Wood. Wood strong again. Mike Harper puts that away. Algonquin had a nice little dig, but Harper says, puts it away.
Yeah, Harper doing a great job catching the Algonquin team off balance there, able to get the kill shot.
Earlier on, Durham's athleticism really coming through. Luke, again, he's been way too strong. He's been hitting them almost at the back of the gym. He's got to settle down.
Yeah, definitely a little excited early on in this one. Trying to make an impact early. It's cost him a couple points now.
Rory Langley gets a favorable bounce off the net. Wood hammers it down for another kill. Algonquin with no answer for Harrison Wood early on. Yeah. 16-9 Durham.
Harrison Wood making a huge impact already. Strong player for Durham. He's going to keep that up all day.
Langley, the jump serve. Neiman up. Nice block there from Wood. Jansen up. Langley's getting called on a lift there. I don't know about that.
A little bit of a late call there. Not sure what happened, but Algonquin's going to get the point here, and they're going to serve again.
Gareth Luke. Langley for Wood again. Just dominant. Harrison Wood. Algonquin with absolutely no response to Harrison Wood early on. I think that's his fifth kill already, and it's 17-10 Durham.
Yeah, Harrison killed, making a huge impact. Harrison Wood.
You might as well change his name to Kill.
Might as well
the way
change his name to Harrison Kill. He's been killing it already.
Jansen with the service. Oh, great dig from Rogers. There we go. Out of bounds, number two. Justin Kingsbury, point Durham. Braden Rogers with an impressive dig there. Jansen, the elder statesman. One of the elder statesmen here for Durham. Third-year player. Unlucky there. Kingsbury up, hammers it home. Wood couldn't get the block. You know, for other teams, having this many first-year players, a bit of a, you know, can be a down sort of thing, but the athletes these first-year players are really kind of changed the team in itself, the makeup.
Yeah, wow. It definitely makes a huge impact. As Watson comes through with a huge kill shot, it's really great to see when those young players can step up and play with, like, their experienced players. It's really going to bode well for this Durham team this season, especially today in this game.
And moving forward in years to come, Durham set up pretty nicely. Harper with the surf. Luke's there. Neiman just kind of smacks it over, but it hits the side of the net. Point Durham. Durham easily in control early on, 20-11. Lord's looking to make quick work of Algonquin here. Harper. Kingsbury. Kingsbury called it a lift. Point Durham again, 21-11.
Yeah, definitely a tough break for Algonquin there. They're just giving away a few points here. They don't want to be doing that. They're down 21-11 here in the first set.
Mike Harper with his third service in a row for Durham. Neiman up. Into the net. Jonah Neiman can't get going early on here for Algonquin. Couple unforced errors.
Yeah, Neiman trying to really hammer that one. Unfortunately, just couldn't get it high enough to get over the net, put it right through the net.
Harper. Kingsbury up. Harrison Wood with the block right back in his face. Wood getting it done on both ends of the net.
Yeah, great job by Harrison Wood. That's a great block. He's using that big body. Stands 6'5" tall. He's going to be using that big body all day and all season for the Lords.
Algonquin may want to avoid Wood. Harper again. Neiman up. Great block. Coleman and Watson together, right back in his face. Nick Coleman, a fifth-year player. Watson, a first-year player. Harper trying to put this one away. Set point. Too strong. I think he was a little amped up. I think he was looking ace there to put that one away.
Yeah, he was definitely trying to end the set there. Unfortunately, just got a little too much of the ball and put it out.
Braden Rogers checks back in for Durham. Jonah Nemeth serves. Wood. Finally, they get a block on. But that's it. Game over. It's the kill. 25-12. Durham makes easy work of Algonquin in the first set. All Harrison Wood. Like 6-7 kills there. I don't have the stat sheet sent to us yet, but Harrison Wood just dominant. No answer from Algonquin.
Yeah, Harrison Wood definitely stepped up big there in that first set. He was a key contributor to the Lords' win. He was all over the floor making great blocks for points, making those great kill shots. And he's definitely been an impact player here early for the Lords.
Well, the way this is going, we'll be home for dinner pretty soon. Yeah.
All right, let's see if we can get a t-shirt thrown up here. Let's start waving our arms. Maybe we'll get a t-shirt thrown up here. Hey, throw a t-shirt up here.
She's not looking at us.
No, she's not paying attention to us. Here I am. Throw it to the commentators. We're doing a great job up here. Chris and I are working hard.
I think it's got a big Harvey's logo on the back.
I think he's got his eye on me.
Yeah.
Oh, no. The young girl down in front there. Lucky fan getting some t-shirts there. Get some lucky fans who want to come up here and we'll sign the t-shirts for them. How does that sound, Chris?
I don't know if I want any evidence that I was here. Yeah.
Couple of the fans there representing the new t-shirts they got.
See, Durham College super fan with a big Harvey's logo on the back. You know, I was I'm a former McDonald's employee, and I've always been loyal to the McD's brand, so I don't know if I could represent the Harvey's.
No, not a Harvey's fan.
Although they got a good veggie burger, so I don't mind them. McD's yet to incorporate a veggie burger into the menu. Burger King's got one. A&W's got a fantastic one. Lick's is the best I've ever had. And Wendy's and McDonald's, the only two with no veggie burgers yet.
It's a tough break for you, I bet.
It's challenging.
You want to try and go to your McDonald's, but they got no burger.
I know. Well, I'm more of a breakfast McDonald's guy. I get that Egg McMuffin going in the morning.
Maybe a coffee and a couple hash browns to go with it, I bet.
You're making me starving, brother, yeah. Although, you know, in the United States, McDonald's has gone to breakfast all day. So any time of day, you can get a, you know, Egg McMuffin or a big breakfast.
But really?
Yes, just about a month or two ago. But we have yet to adopt that here in Canada.
I would love that. I might be at McDonald's every day, though. I love those sausage McMuffins, a couple hash browns, and a coffee, and you're good to go for the day.
You could get a little late night McD's breakfast after a pub night at E.P. Taylor's here on the Durham campus. Definitely help your sleep a little easier.
Yeah.
Our second set about to get started. On the floor for Durham, Harrison Wood, Tyler Cravey seeing his first action. With Andrew Watson, Braden Rogers, Eric Jansen, Rory Langley. Cravey number four checking in from Stouffville, another sports admin student, first year player. Looks as though Neiman will be serving for Algonquin to get things started. Neiman Neiman, the big man, puts it in. Rogers is there. Langley comes to help out. Wood too strong this time. For the first time today, Harrison Wood misses.
I think that's his first miss. Maybe we're complimenting him between sets again.
Yeah, I gotta start slagging these guys, and then maybe they'll get something done. And then as soon as we compliment and praise how well they're playing, it always ends up going the other way.
Yeah.
Neiman serves 1-0. Too strong.
It looks like I hit the line judge down there. Hopefully she's okay.
Yeah.
We never want to see those line judges get hurt.
Jansen doesn't like the ball, wants it switched up. Jansen from Curtis High School at Hampton, Ontario. Nice serve in. Luke up. Great block from Wood. Mistimed. But nonetheless, Watson just kind of swats it in, works out all right. They mistimed the set there, but worked out okay for Durham.
Yeah, great save earlier in that sequence by the Thunder Amlet from Cornwall, Ontario. He made a great diving play there to keep the ball alive. Unfortunately, Algonquin just couldn't get the point.
Luke. Back to Wood again, up. Just out, unlucky. Harrison Wood missed by just an inch or two on the near baseline.
Yeah,
touchline, excuse me.
Able to just sneak it in there. The Algonquin player tried to argue briefly, but to no prevail.
Eric Jansen. Actually, it looks like he did get the point. We're giving it to him. One of the Algonquin guys must have got a piece of it.
Oh, it just stayed in the line.
Watson up. Point, Andrew Watson. Watson got up on that one, hammered it with authority. Jansen with his fourth service in a row. Durham leads 4-1. Great dig. Eric Jansen with a great dig, but no one could help him out there. Good effort.
Yeah, just an unfortunate break. Looked like the couple of Lords players were unsure that the ball was heading in that direction. They just couldn't save it there for Jansen.
James Amelot serves for the first time. First-year player. Gets the point. Amelot, from what I've researched, pretty good baseball player. Played in the Inter-County League. Checked him out. He had a 5-1 record as a pitcher a couple years ago in the Inter-County League. He's a 19-year-old. Watson up. Andrew Watson with the kill. He was like he was suspended in air for a few seconds.
Yeah, he definitely had great hang time on that play. It was great to see, and then finished it off with the kill.
Durham, far superior athletes on their side of the ball. Really starting to show now. Amelot, nice play, nice touch. Keeping Algonquin in the game single-handedly.
Amelot making a big impact already. A couple of big plays. Algonquin's going to need him to step up, and he's going to need some other players to help him out.
A.J. Westcarth with his first service for Algonquin today. Wood up. Calling a net violation there, unlucky. Algonquin relying on cheap breaks to sort of have an answer for Wood. Durham got to keep feeding the big man. Westcarth serves again. Is that Nick Coleman this time, number 10. Coleman out of Brooklyn, Ontario, not far from Durham. The Durham campus, I should say. Wood with the service. Neiman sets. Awkward set. Patterson, I think he got a piece of the net there. It was called before it even went up.
Yeah, it looks like the player who is setting the ball is getting called with a two hit.
Harrison Wood with service. Luke from the back. Poorly taken. I think he'd have been better served just to kind of get that over. Went for a spike with the ball kind of drifting towards the back. Not the best technique from Luke there.
No, it looked like he didn't get a comfortable ball there. It was kind of floating behind him, and he had to come behind the ball. Didn't work out for him.
What a block. Rory Langley in that one.
It's a great block there by Rory Langley. Lords are going to need more of those blocks. Don't let Algonquin try and attack their net presence like that.
The six-foot Langley went up there against the much bigger opponent. Still showed his hops, came up with a block. Wood too strong on the service there. 9-6 Durham. Gareth Luke will serve for Algonquin. Too strong. Nick Coleman. Yeah. Langley had a nice set. Coleman just a little too strong there.
Yeah, unfortunate break for the Lords there. Coleman had a nice set for him. He just got too much of the ball there.
Watson up again. Andrew Watson. The first game was all Wood. The second game, all Watson.
Yeah, nice to see when those other players will step up and make an impact in a set and try and seal one for your team.
Watson normally plays on the left side, 6-2 player. Powerful running jump serve. Luke goes into the stands, can't save it. Gareth Luke almost pulled his Josh Donaldson diving into the stands there to try to keep that play alive. Not with the same results as Donaldson though.
No, not the same results, but the effort was there. Just couldn't get it back over the net for this team.
Watson serves again. Too strong. Really an elaborate technique with his serve. Tosses the ball a good 15-20 feet in the air.
Yeah, trying to create that hard downspin so that the ball just dives straight down into the floor, making it more difficult to keep the ball up. Just didn't work out for the Lords on that one.
Bloom with the service. Rogers just keeps it in play. Rory Langley with the block. Well played. But, oh, he did get the point. Nick Coleman lists on his resume that he's a part-time model. I've been thinking about throwing that on my resume as well.
Part-time model.
For big, tall, and ugly is what I'll be the part-time model for.
Somebody's got to fill that role.
Yeah. Amelot up. Watson gets called for a lift. For me, that was a good save. Watson not impressed with that call.
Yeah, Watson disagreeing with the call. Unfortunately, the referee made the decision. And they're going to have to live with it and move forward from here.
Durham 13-9 up. And Patterson gets a favorable bounce off the top of the net. That's twice that's happened to Algonquin.
Yeah, just those funky serves that hit the top of the net and just kind of fall in. Works out for Algonquin already.
And then he gets it again. Langley saves it. Neiman for Luke, way too strong. That's about the fourth time Luke's hammered that way into the back of the gym. He's got to settle down.
Yeah, Luke definitely really excited in this one. Trying to make that big impact hit because they know they're playing a strong team like Durham and they're going to be doing it and he's trying to just do it too, that's all.
I think Luke guilty of trying to get 3 points on one play.
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't think he can do that in volleyball.
Yeah.
I know I've only seen a game or two in my lifetime, but you can't do that. It doesn't happen.
Rory Langley now with service for Durham, leading 15-10 in the second set. Up 1-0. Westcarth blocked. Eric Jansen at the net. Algonquin just no answer for the athleticism of Durham right now. They're bigger. They're more athletic.
Yeah, Durham definitely playing a very smart and strong game. Really attacking Algonquin here. As Algonquin gets the point on that play.
Michael Ryan Bloom from the back row. Got a fortunate bounce. Neiman out of London, Ontario, first year player, 6'4". impressive high school career in the London area. Trying to make a name for himself in the OCAA.
Yeah, unfortunately, just got too much of that ball. Ball ended up going long and out of play.
Jansen with the service. Amelot, great save by Langley. Amelot again. The man's got some hops.
Yeah, great job by Amelot. It didn't work out the first time, but the second time he came through with a big kill.
Spencer Edwards checking in for the first time here for Durham.
Yeah, it looks like Jansen's going to take a seat. Edwards is going to see some action here in the second set.
Edwards, first-year player out of Vineland, Ontario, down in the Niagara region.
Edwards, the two-sport athlete, as he played on the men's baseball team, as well as now joining the men's volleyball team.
Amelot serves, and then Edwards gets called with a lift. Still hasn't shaken baseball season off of him yet early on.
No, a couple rough goes there in the baseball season for the team, but hopefully things will turn around here.
Two plays in a row, Edwards gets called on the same lift. Not a good way to introduce yourself to the lineup, Spencer.
No, just a little shaky early on here. Let's see if he can turn things around.
Another one of those Rec and Leisure students. Rogers shows Edwards how it's done. Harrison Wood. Ladies and gentlemen, Harrison Wood. Harrison Wood just absolutely dominating this game here. 18-15 Durham.
Yeah, great job by Harrison Wood, jumping up, using that big body to get the kill shot.
Cravey checks in now, number four, serving for the first time today. Too strong, hits it out wide.
When are we going to change Harrison Wood's name to Harrison Kill?
The way he's playing, you know. He's on pace for an all-Canadian type season, the way he's playing early on. Never mind OCAA. Wow. Nick Coleman, dominant. Coleman really, he's got some vertical on him there. Goes up and shows it. Hammers that one away.
Yeah, Coleman, the big, tall, 6'2", fifth-year player out of Brooklyn. Definitely using that big body and able to get that kill shot on that play.
Wood with the service. Bloom can't handle it. Out of bounds, easy point for Durham. 2016 lead here in the second set. Harrison Woods had a good run of service all day.
Harrison Woods had a great run of everything.
Everything,
so
that's right.
A couple big blocks, a couple kill shots.
Poor set there. Tim Young getting in for the first time, the libero, number five. Not quite comfortable leaving Bloom hanging out to dry there on that set. Algonquin wants a timeout. This is a long one. 21-16, Durham up in the second set with a one-set lead. We're going to take a break. We'll see you after this. Back to the action. We were supposed to go to a break. Harrison Wood serving again for Durham. Neiman for Luke. Gareth Luke finally catches a break there. Nick Coleman got a piece of it, but it just too much force on it. No one else from Durham can get it. Kyler Woodburn now checking in, seeing his first action for Durham. Edwards finally gets that one right. Watson up. Andrew Watson hammers that away. Really impressive.
Yeah, great job by Watson. All set up there by the great first hit by Spencer Edwards. I think the nerves are out of him now. Hopefully, anyways, he's going to play some good volleyball from here on out.
Watson serves with Durham up 22-17, trying to put this one away. Get a 2-0 lead for Durham early on. Watson up. Ooh, just missed. A little too strong from Watson there.
Yeah, it looks like he got a good piece of that ball. Unfortunately, it just drifted out.
Michael Ryan Bloom from Muskoka. Langley sets. Coleman went under the net, unlucky. Langley kind of hung out Coleman to dry there. Coleman was ready to hammer that away. Langley didn't get enough air on that set for him.
Yeah, Coleman looked a little uncomfortable going up, and as he came down, it looked like he stepped on over that bottom line under the net and got hit with that net violation.
Bloom. Edwards sets. Edwards up. Great dig from Luke. Net violation. Jonah Neiman. Durham gets the point. Nick Coleman now serving. Durham up 23-19, trying to put this one away.
Yeah, Lord's in a good spot here. They got one of their better players serving. They're going to try and get 2 points here and get the win.
Luke hits that one to Pickering. That one that went past Whitby, Ajax on my front lawn in Pickering. Luke's got to work on that in practice, methinks.
Oh, look, oh, he did get all of it, but looks like there's a, maybe there's something out of the net that got called. Algonquin steals the point.
Edwards with a nice dig. From the back, Watson. Net violation, Andrew Watson. Just too much force on that leap, kind of brought him onto the net. Unlucky.
Yeah, you can see him really attack the net, trying to get a kill shot. Unfortunately, got hit with the net violation.
Algonquin hanging around here. Craby. Sorry, Woodburn there. He didn't get all of it, but he got enough to get the point. Durham up 24-21, set point. Rory Langley will serve to put this one away.
Yeah, it looked like he just kind of planned to roll that one a little bit farther and end up dropping in for the point.
Langley. Luke's there. Amelot, too strong. They're looking for a touch. Ah, the ref gives it to him. That's a gift if you ask me. Amelot looks like he just hammered that one way out.
Yeah, it looks like Kyler Woodburn got hit with the touch call, unfortunately, for the Lords. They're going to need a stop here to get the set win.
Algonquin with a stay of execution there, down by two. Neiman serving. Way too strong, Edwards. 24-23 now. Coach Matsusaki got away from his starting rotation. Giving Algonquin life here now. There it is. Game over, Durham. Tyler Craby hammered that one down with the kill. Algonquin got a piece of it, but not enough. Durham takes the second set. 2-0. 25-23, Durham. Durham cruising easily in control here. Without their best player, still sort of coasting with ease. Mike, what's Algonquin got to do to get back in this?
The big thing that Algonquin needs to do, they can't be having the errors on the court. Durham just keeps on taking advantage of those errors. They get the ball for service, and they're making great serves to stay in advantage of this game. Algonquin can't be afford to be doing that all day.
Yeah, it's almost like they got to play a perfect game here just to stay in it.
Yeah, and then every time Durham does make an error for themselves, Algonquin needs to take advantage for sure in order to have a chance to come back in this one. It's going to be tough. It is doable, but it's going to be really tough for them to make an attempt to come back here.
Doesn't look like they have the horses to compete with Durham just yet, and if they do get back in, it's Durham sort of shooting themselves in the foot with unforced errors.
Absolutely. Algonquin's got 9 first-year players on their team. Definitely a young team. They're struggling early on. They haven't won a game yet. Only been able to win a few sets, but they're going to move forward as a team. They're going to try and come together, and they're going to try and build for the future. That's going to be hopefully a success for them later on.
Durham with 9 first-year players of their own as well. A lot of them contributing big minutes tonight, including Rory Langley, Harrison Wood, and Andrew Watson. Albatross was doing hit from, it was in some car commercial, and then it became like a big commercial hit.
A little bit of music going on in the background as the boys get sorted out and take a break between sets here.
Big win for the Durham ladies earlier. A little bit more of a closer contest, evenly matched, but Durham still coming out on top 3-1. Lady Lords dropping their first set of the season. Blemished the perfect record, but still got the big W regardless.
Yeah, Lord's able to win that one, 3-1. I think Algonquin ladies team deserved a better fate in that game. They definitely played better. The score doesn't really reflect how they played. They played hard all game with a couple of close sets that Durham was able to sneak the win out of.
Yeah, it didn't do them justice. I thought that one was going 5 sets for sure, but I think Durham just kind of dug a little deeper in key moments and pulled that one out. But I think, going up against Algonquin again later in the season, the outcome may be different.
Yeah, definitely. Algonquin's going to be ready for them next time they see each other in the season or even in a tournament, wherever they might see them. They're going to be ready to play as we get ready to play the third set here between the men's Algonquin team and the men's Durham team.
Here we go for the third set. Durham leading 2-0. On the floor now for Durham, Rory Langley, Andrew Watson, Mike Harper. Kyle Conker, number 12, checks in for the first time. Harrison Wood and Eric Jansen. Conker out of Ajax, Pickering High School. He's a marketing student here at Durham, seeing his first action here in the third set. Langley serves. Lift from Luke, easy call for the ref.
Yeah, Gareth Luke, the Ottawa native, definitely struggling early in this one. Well, as we reach the third set, a couple of hard hits earlier in the game that went out of bounds, and now that lift call.
Luke trying to redeem. Harrison Wood there to block. Eric Jansen, right back at him. Jansen likes that one. He's feeling that one.
Yeah, Jansen, the third-year player, jumped up there and made sure to get the kill shot there on the Algonquin players.
Luke up, calling a net violation there, not sure on who. Had the champ bumped into some of the men's volleyball players in the campus gym here Monday night, all working out together. Eric Jansen leading the workouts for his younger teammates.
Great to see when the veteran players step up and help the young players out like that.
Lead by example.
Really brings the team together and really makes it more of a team dynamic exercise.
Amelot serves for Algonquin. Wood up. Great dig. Algonquin keeping alive. Jansen up. Eric Jansen puts it away. Some great effort there from Algonquin to keep that alive, but just the power and athleticism of Durham. Too much to deal with.
Yeah, Jansen's just too big and too strong and too powerful here for the Algonquin team.
Jansen serves with Durham leading 3-2 in the third. Big point. Derek Westerman with the kill. Westerman seeing his first action here, the first-year player from Bowmanville. He's got a good look going with the long hair and the headband.
Sure, this feels good for Westerman playing close to home. It's always nice when you can sneak home when you're away at school.
Westerman, no doubt familiar with many of the Durham players. Langley for Wood. Wood again. Harrison Wood with the kill. Nope, out of bounds. Look good from here, but
I guess that's why we're the commentators up high.
Yeah, I wish we could hear a beep or something if it was out of bounds. Westerman with the serve. Watson called it a lift there. Unlucky. Algonquin with an early lead here in the third, showing signs of life.
Yeah, Algonquin showing some life here. Definitely going to try and fight to get back in this game. They're going to need a big set win here.
Oh, clever play. Rory Langley. He had Conker there ready for the set, and everyone just kind of bit on it. Langley, clever play. Really enjoyed that.
Yeah, really clever play right there. You could hear Kyle Conker coming through yelling, yeah, 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 like he wanted the ball. And unfortunately for Conker, he didn't get it, but Rory Langley gets the point for the Lords.
Conker serves for the first time today. Luke up. Too strong again. That is the seventh, I believe, time Gareth Luke's hit that too strong out the back.
Yeah, he's definitely getting up there. He's just hitting the ball too hard. Still very jittery. Maybe getting a little frustrated with himself now.
Needs to take the advice of Aaron Rodgers and R-E-L-A-X, relax. Steven Patterson doesn't need to relax. Great kill there. The big man gets up, hammers that one away.
Yeah, great job by Patterson using that big body. 6'10 and a 6'3". Can really get up there and use that power on the ball.
When they've sort of directed things toward him, he's been dominant. You'd like to see Algonquin go a bit more to him. Harrison Wood again with another kill.
Yeah, Harrison Wood doing a great job again. And as we're going to start calling him Harrison Kill, because he's just keep on getting those kill shots all day.
Wood. Too strong. Justin Kingsbury, too strong for Algonquin.
Yeah, again, those errors by Algonquin. They're just making a couple mental errors, and it's costing them here. They can't afford giving away points to the Lords like this.
Luke, no. Andrew Wright there, seeing his first action, libero. Checking in number 15. Coach Matsusaki using his full bench tonight, more so than I've seen him use all season.
Yeah, he's definitely trying to get everybody some work here, let them get a feel for things. They have a lot of first-year players again this year, with a few players retiring last year.
Kingsbury just serves that one into the net, not helping the cause. Watson again. Dramatic pause effect there from Watson. Ugly lift. Just poor timing. Neiman, he had Patterson there for, just didn't get the right set.
Yeah, I just couldn't get under the ball properly. Instead, he got hit with the lift call.
9-7 Durham. Watson serves again. I'm waiting for him to start reciting some Shakespeare. This long pause. Patterson, Harper's there to answer for Durham, though. Out of bounds. Were you ever forced to remember any Shakespeare in your high school days?
Yeah, we had to do Romeo and Juliet. Macbeth was another one I had to do.
I still have the opening soliloquy of The Merchant of Venice memorized. Watson. Neiman sets back for Luke. Wright's there for Durham. Kind of missed time, net violation on Neiman. Harper missed time the jump, but just cleverly smacked it over, placed it well. Point Durham.
You could see Luke there earlier in that sequence, went with a little bit of a softer touch, and he was able to get the ball over the net. As we saw earlier, every time he went hard with a power shot, he was putting a little long and out.
Line violation there. Watson came over the line. He got away from that big elaborate serve and tried to do a little bit more, you know, a basic effort, and it didn't work out for him. Stick to what works.
Yeah, he just came and stepped on that line right as he went to serve it. It didn't help anyways. The ball was going to come a little bit short of the net.
Steven Patterson, but the lone bright spot for Algonquin. Serving. Neiman to Amelot. Into the net. 12-8 Durham. Wright takes the seat with Conker checking back in, number 12. This is the most action he's seen so far this season.
Yeah, nice to see when you can get those young players a little bit of action and some the meaningful games as opposed to those tournament exhibition games as Harper serves that ball into the net.
You know, I started off by saying Harper was probably the best server on Durham, and he's put two into the net already tonight.
There we go again, complimenting people.
Jonah Neiman now for Algonquin. Just again with the unforced error for Algonquin.
Yeah, those unforced errors are really costing Algonquin. They can't afford to be giving away points like that. It's going to cost them here in the third set. Hopefully the Lords can take advantage here.
Rory Langley. Ah, poor set from Neiman there. He had Westerman in a good position to set it, and just you could tell he was trying to maybe catch Durham off guard there, but caught himself off guard and hit that one into the net.
Yeah, it looked like he tried to do a little sneaky soft touch over the net. Unfortunately, didn't get enough of it and got hit with a double hit.
Too strong. Amelot again. Durham easily in control, just cruising here. Algonquin wants a timeout. We're going to think about it. 15-9 here in the third set. Durham cruising. We're going to stay with it during the break.
Yeah, you can see the Algonquin coach over there talking to his players, trying to sort out how they're going to try and come back in this one. They obviously don't want to be giving up more points than what they have, or else it's just going to create a bigger deficit for them here. They're already down by six against this very strong and powerful Durham Lords team.
I think sometimes when you know you're overmatched, it might just be an opportunity to get a decent rotation of players, get everybody in the game, get everyone some minutes.
Yeah, let everyone try and feel it out. Maybe get a little bit of work in, and hopefully it'll bode well for them. Looks like a lot of their players, they were never comfortable in this game. They just haven't been able to get comfortable. A couple of their players feeling a little bit of the maybe tension or the pressure to try and come up big against this powerful Durham team.
Langley serves. Luke. Finally, Luke gets one in there. Nice kill from Gareth Luke. Too strong for Andrew Wright there. James Amelot now serving for Algonquin. Kyle Conker went up there, couldn't get it. Number 15, Derek Westerman there with the block.
Yeah, great job by Westerman getting up at the net and able to block that ball. Conker unable to get the kill shot down.
Wood. Nice save by Algonquin. Eric Jansen, great block from Algonquin. Watson keeps it alive. So does Langley. Luke. Gareth Luke finally settling down. That's two in a row now. Two kills in a row for Gareth Luke.
Yeah, Gareth Luke with two kill shots in a row there. Nice to see him come up with a kill shot after a few that didn't work out so well for him earlier in the game.
Amelot serves with Algonquin down 15-12 in the third. Jansen. Into the net again. Point Algonquin.
Yeah, Jansen just maybe didn't have the timing set right there with the ball. Unfortunately, just couldn't get the good kill shot off like we've seen earlier in the game from him.
Durham gone away from feeding Harrison Wood. Might want to get back to that tactic. And on cue, Harrison Wood. Thank you very much.
On cue, you called it right there, Chris. Harrison Wood with a great kill, or as we're calling him, Harrison Kill, comes through with another kill for the Lords.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Keep feeding the big man.
Exactly.
Algonquin's had no answer for him all day.
The big bear has been hungry today, and he's been just eating them up.
Jansen too strong on the service there. Westerman now serving for Algonquin, with them trailing by two in the third. 16-14 with the lead, Durham. Right. Wood again. Harrison Wood again. That's easy a dozen kills for him.
Absolutely. Harrison Wood playing some great ball right now. He just keeps on getting that ball set up for him, and he's taking full advantage, and he's not missing.
Wood padding the stats today. It's got to put him among the provincial leaders in kills. Too strong. Is that West card up? Too much. 18-14. Conqueror will serve again. Second set of service for Kyle. Getting a good run of form here. Kyle with a nice serve. Luke up again. Jansen with the dig. Langley helps him out. Watson gets it over. Nice defense from Durham. Luke hits it to Ajax this time.
Yeah, well, at least he's getting a little bit closer back to Oshawa.
Getting closer here to Oshawa, yeah.
Put one in Pickering earlier on your front lawn. Now he just put one in someone's backyard over in Ajax there.
Conquer serves with Durham up 19-14. Nice save from Kingsbury. Jansen for Watson. Nice dig from Algonquin. Luke again. Luke finally catches a break. He had Harper and Watson there on the block, just didn't get enough of it.
Yeah, Harper and Watson both going up for the block there. Unfortunately, neither one of them could get a clean block. They tipped it and hit the floor. Unfortunate break for the Lords. They got a 4-point lead here still in the third set.
Adam Waller checks in for Luke now. Seen his first action since early on. The starter that kind of sat on the bench for a while. Maybe that's why.
Yeah, Waller just served that one into the net. Sarnia native second-year player, unfortunately. They're going to need him to step up big here as Kyle Roy steps in. He's going to see his first action of the game.
Kyle Roy, the big man from Brooklyn. Got a powerful serve. Opted for touch there. And cleverly placed. Kyle Roy. It's funny, the other players on the team seem to really react when Kyle gets in and gets some minutes. Definitely well liked amongst the guys on the team.
Yeah, definitely one of those team players that everybody loves. It's nice to have those players. They're always key contributors off the field, more so than on the field. They always keep the guys on the bench focused and in the game, and it's nice to see him step up big there with a big serve for the Lords.
Big man, big frame on him. Gives me hope that, you know, maybe I can make the volleyball team next year.
Yeah, the big man definitely showing off that he's got some athletic ability hidden there.
Durham up 21-15 in the third set. Looking to ice this one. Put the women and children to bed and let's go looking for dinner.
Yeah, Lord's going to try and put this one away here. Roy's going to serve and hopefully they can get out of here quickly with a quick three-set victory.
Kyle Roy, 6'1", third-year player. He's a science and engineering prep student here at Durham. Roy serves again. Kingsbury up. Roy, great dig by Langley. Jansen keeps it in play. Patterson too strong. He gets the point. Patterson got a piece of one of the Durham guys. Steven Patterson.
Yeah, Patterson again with another kill shot. He's been playing great so far. A couple kills already. Really getting up there at the net for the kills.
Jason LaFleur seeing his first action here in the third set. Number four. No relation to Guy. Langley for Watson. It looked as though one of the Algonquin guys got it. Well, now the side judge has overruled the head ref, saying Algonquin did get a piece of it. That was pretty obvious from here. Ref missed that one. Thankfully. Yeah.
Looked like a little confusion between the two officials. Luckily, it looks like they got the call right. And it was a tip against the Algonquin player.
Cooler heads prevail, and the point does go to Durham. Watson tying his shoelaces as if the long, prolonged serve wasn't enough. He's now drawing it out even further, making the entire gym wait for him to tie his shoes. Gives the thumbs up. He's ready to serve. After all that, he better hammer this one proper.
Yeah, hopefully the shoe wasn't the problem.
Watson with the service. Neiman up. Point Durham, hit it out of bounds. Hit Jansen in his face, couldn't get it around him, hit him out of bounds.
Yeah, unfortunate break there for Algonquin. The Algonquin player had Jansen right there at the net. Couldn't get around him, so he had to hit it out of bounds, unfortunately.
Watson in. Amelot's there. Right with the dig for Durham. Andrew Watson hammers it away, kills it. 24-16, Durham College.
Great job by Watson there with the kill. He's going to go back and serve again.
Algonquin, just no answers at all. Watson here for match point. And Patterson keeps Algonquin alive. See, all day long it's been there for Patterson. They're just not feeding him enough.
Yeah, Patterson just wasn't getting the ball throughout the day. The few times that he was getting the ball set up for him, he's taking full advantage and getting those kill shots for Algonquin Thunder.
Patterson serves, trying to keep Algonquin alive. Langley sets for Harper. Timing off. Neiman, too strong. Game, set, match, Durham College. Durham cruises to an easy 3-0 victory, 25-17 here in the third set. Durham keeps their record perfect in the early season, 4-0. Definitely looking to improve on that number 4 ranking. From the Campus Recreation Wellness Center, I'm Chris McKee with Mike Chilvers. Thanks for joining us today. Don't forget, you can check this out on YouTube, as on the Durham Lords Network, as well as the Ustream Durham Lords Network. We'll see you next weekend.